Do you know that 40% of oncology patients develop signs of malnutrition during treatment? Do you know that 20% of oncology patients die from nutrition complications rather than cancer? Nutrition is extremely important for managing cancer patients, but unfortunately does not get the same attention as other active treatments. Why is good nutrition important? Bad nutrition is associated with poor responses to treatment. Patients have a higher risk of chemotherapy side effects. There's also an increased risk of dying from cancer. There's also an increased risk of suffering complications during treatment, like infections, for example. Good nutrition, on the other hand, makes you stronger, makes you feel better, makes you tolerate chemotherapy better with less side effects. Cancer patients suffer significant weight loss during treatment. This is one of the signs of bad nutrition. So what causes weight loss in cancer patients? Cancer cells secrete chemicals that causes inflammation in the body, which can lead to increased metabolism. These cells also secrete chemicals that can suppress appetite, so food intake or calorie intake is decreased. Chemicals secreted from the tumors can lead to breakdown of fat and muscle, causing weight loss. Cancer patients also have an inefficient metabolic system, which basically means that the food you consume is not utilized into the body. Let us discuss about how doctors do nutritional assessment in cancer patients. One way is to calculate what is called BMI. BMI stands for body mass index. BMI is calculated using body weight in kilos divided by height in meters squared. BMI of 20 to 24.9 is normal. 25 to 29.9 is considered overweight, and 30 to 39.9 is considered obese, and more than 40 is considered morbidly obese. Example, if your weight is 75 kilos and height is 70 inches, your BMI is considered as 24. Assessing nutrition based on actual body weight is another way to assess your nutritional status. From a baseline weight, a 10% weight loss in 6 months, or 7.4% in 3 months, or more than 2% in a week is associated with severe risk of malnutrition. What are the typical dietary needs in cancer patients? These patients need more calories than a healthy patient or healthy person. Patients will need at least 30 calories per kilo for a 70 kilo man, that equals 2,100 calories per day. Best source are carbohydrates from fruits, vegetables, and whole grain. Protein is an important ingredient for cancer patients. Protein is necessary for healing. Protein requirements are about 50% more than healthy individuals, which is about 1.5 grams per kilo per day. Good source of proteins include tofu, soy, lentils, beans, peas, nuts, lean meat, eggs, and low-fat dairy. Fats also serve as a rich source of energy. Choose monounsaturated and polyunsaturated oils derived from plants, such as canola, olive oil, peanuts, sunflower oil, flaxseed oil, over saturated fat from animals. Fiber is an important ingredient obtained from plant-based food. Insoluble fiber in the skin of the fruit and vegetable helps to move food waste out quickly, and soluble fiber seen within the fruit mixes with water and makes soft stool. Water intake of at least 8 ounces of liquids are recommended, or 2 liters per day. Vitamins and minerals are necessary. There is no need for routine supplementation if you're taking a balanced diet. Antioxidants are important. Antioxidants such as vitamin A, C, E, selenium, and zinc are important. Fruits and vegetables are the rich source in antioxidants. Avoid large amounts during cancer treatment since they can potentially interfere with the effects of chemotherapy. Limit intake of sugar and processed food. Snack often. Don't wait for hunger to develop. How does a dietitian counsel help in cancer patients? Counseling by a registered dietitian has been shown to improve quality of life. It also improves the nutritional status of the patient. You can find a nutritionist at your local hospital or at eatright.org. I'm showing you the website picture here. Let us discuss some specific situations for cancer patients. Cancer patients who completed treatments and are healthy otherwise, we call them survivors. I recommend they watch a video on diets. I made a video on diets, the good, the bad, and the ugly. All those recommendations apply to them for a healthy living as well as to decrease the risk of cancer coming back. So what is the kind of planning you have to do before chemo? Stock your favorite food. Involve family and friends with regard to shopping and cooking. Keep favorite snacks handy. On the day of the chemo, take a light meal. Other issues that are common in cancer patients include poor appetite. Poor appetite is a major issue in active cancer patients and also as a consequence of treatments, especially chemotherapy. If poor appetite is from cancer itself, treating cancer successfully helps improve appetite. Small and frequent meals to maintain calorie intake is recommended. Also, avoid drinking too much plain water, since excess water can suppress appetite. Instead, obtain water through nutritious beverages such as fruit smoothies, soya milk, soup, or commercially available meal replacement plans. Sometimes, if indicated, your doctor can prescribe a medication to stimulate appetite, such as megestrol, also known as megase, or dronabinol. Early satiety is another common problem seen in cancer patients. Some patients get full eating only small amounts of food. These patients can benefit from calorie-dense food such as seeds, nuts, and cheese. Other common problems seen is taste, lack of taste, and altered smell. This can happen when chemotherapy kills sensory cells in the tongue and the nose. It can also happen with radiation therapy and surgeries to the head and neck area. Here are the few tips when you have a bad taste in your mouth or you're not able to smell. Eat fresh food. Try different food varieties. Try different spices, herbs, sauces, and flavors to enhance the taste. For bitter tasting foods, add sugar. For foods which are too sweet, add water or salt. For metallic taste, use citrus fruits, and smoothies. Food may sometimes taste better or smell better when cold or frozen. It is worth a try to try food in a cold state. Zinc supplements can help sometimes. Other problem that is commonly seen in cancer patients is mucositis. It is a condition when a lot of sores in the mouth from chemotherapy or radiation. Patients have difficulty eating food because of pain. Recommendations including avoiding acidic food like citrus fruits, do not eat dry, avoid coarse food, avoid spicy food, carbonated drinks and alcohol. Eat soft, bland foods. Liquefy the food and drink with a straw. Baking soda rinse will prevent infections in the mouth. A mouthwash to help with pain is available through a prescription. It is called magic mouthwash. Other common problem seen is dry mouth. This can be from radiation to the head and neck area. A dry mouth can increase the risk of infection. Drink plenty of fluids. Eat moist food like fruits and avocados, potato, corn, pasta, legumes, boiled rice, oils, desserts, etc. Take small bites. Chew well. Stimulate saliva secretion with citrus juice, sugarless gum. Avoid alcohol. Limit caffeinated beverages. Other common problem seen is malabsorption of food. This can be seen in cancer patients, especially pancreatic cancer patients. Patients will need to take pancreatic enzyme supplements with each meal. Other common problem seen is nausea after chemotherapy. Recommendations include frequent meals, eat dry food, avoid greasy food, avoid spicy food, food with strong odor. One more common problem seen is swallowing issues in cancer patients. A speech therapy evaluation will recommend exact diet that can be taken in this situation. If thickened products are recommended, use gelatin, tapioca, cornstarch, baby cereal, or a commercial thickener. If thin liquids are recommended, use coffee, tea, and thin soups. For thick liquids, use buttermilk, ice cream, and milkshakes. Other common problem is diarrhea. Some tips for this include decrease lactose in the diet. That means decreasing the milk intake, decreasing fat intake by decreasing greasy food, decrease spicy food, decrease insoluble fiber that is typically seen in seeds, skin or produce, and wheat bran. Increase soluble fiber, which is typically seen in peeled fruit, oat bran, avocados, figs, beans, pears, and broccoli. Increase sodium in the diet with soups, pretzels, and crackers. Increase potassium in the diet because people with diarrhea lose potassium. Use sports drinks, bananas, fruit juices. Yogurt and buttermilk is good. They provide probiotics. Call your physician if diarrhea is not improving. Constipation is another common problem. It can be from chemotherapy or pain medications that you take for cancer. Recommend plenty of fluids, drinking hot fluids in the morning time, eat fiber-containing foods. Laxatives may help if above recommendations fail. Exercise on a regular basis also helps with constipation. Also, when you're dealing with a weak immune system sometimes, Recommendations include washing hands with soap and water at least 20 seconds before eating. Keep kitchen clean with bleach or disinfectants. Clean food well. Make sure food is cooked well in high temperature. Store food in a refrigerator less than 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Do not eat ice cream from ice cream dispensers or machines. Avoid raw vegetables and fruits when eating out. Avoid fresh juices in restaurants because there's a potential for contamination. There's one more common problem that we see in cancer patients: fatigue. Recommendations include staying fully hydrated, eat healthy. Exercise will counter fatigue. Find a way to do exercise daily. It could be as simple as a short walk. Address other causes of fatigue like lack of sleep, anemia, stress, and depression. A lot of patients can have diabetes, type 2 diabetes, and on medication. Recommendations include following a diabetic meal plan. Talk to your doctor or endocrinologist for appropriate recommendations for insulin or diabetic medication. There are some specific situations where patients will need what is called enteral nutrition. This is used in specific situations where a person is not able to eat or swallow. Examples include a gastrostomy tube placement as well as jejunostomy tube placement, where an artificial feeding tube is placed into the stomach or into the small bowel. Artificial feeding can help with weight loss, especially in patients receiving radiation therapy to the head and neck area. These measures will also decrease the need for hospitalization secondary to dehydration or weight loss. Other modality for nutrition include total parenteral nutrition. In this particular situation, the GI tract is not available for nutrition. Nutrition is given through the IV. This can be considered in patients with severe malnourishment. Can also be used in situations where patients have surgery and are not expected to eat for more than 10 days. Conclusion: we can say that nutrition is extremely important for a cancer patient, especially when they're going through treatment, because it improves quality of life, it improves their functional status, it also improves outcomes with treatment. These guidelines are for education purposes only. For your specific nutritional needs, you may have to contact your physician. Thank you for watching.